Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews and me, Terry Kay. And we've got what is, I believe, a Polish beer, Perla. And it's Mocne. From what I can see of the language, it looks Polish anyway. But I speak very little Polish. Mówię bardzo mało po polsku. And that, a Kropna, I believe. So, gagging to go for this, really gagging to go for it. Mocne, I think, is just means like strong. So I'm not sure the ABV on this. 7.6, woo! So along with that, hopefully, will be a nice barley sort of meaty taste. Because I'm after something with a bit of flavour. And I have found that a lot of the kind of Eastern European beers are quite flavoursome. They don't mess about. So let's go for it. Crack. It hasn't erupted. Let's see what we get coming out. There are a lot of the breweries over there seem to be kind of owned by Carlsbergs and things like that, and Heineken's and all that business. But I think this one's just completely separate. I don't know. If you know, the whole idea of community, kind of like YouTube community, I'm not just broadcasting at you. If you know, let me know, because I don't like to read up too much, because you get a lot of kind of preconceived taste notes. So let's pour this left-handed rest of this, because I'm ambiguous. I poured quite a head on the first bit. I'm going to leave a little bit left in the can. I've got it in my little jar, so I can reseal it for later if I don't drink it. There's the carbonation. It's kind of fairly gentle looking, but it's a big booming head on it, big kaplunky head. Looks a bit soap suds and all that, you know. So I don't know what to make of the head, but it's not smelling bad. It's not smelling that kind of pissy cardboardy sort of thing. Getting quite gentle notes for a strong beer. You can smell, not the box over there. I've got them packed right in here. I've got my boxes packed so high now, you know. It's terrible, isn't it? Picking up little kind of gentle biscuity notes, bit of Garibaldi, a bit of the kind of currants, slightly burnt currants. Little bit of toasty, lovely toasty bread with toasty kind of marmalade-y bread. Maybe a bit of peanut butter as well on it. Try this, by the way. Little bit of peanut butter, little tiny bit of marmalade. Smack it under the grill, like grill it up first, then smack it back under the grill, just let it melt a little bit, and then off you go. Beautiful stuff. Right, not picking up much on the nose, so I'm diving straight in. Cheers. Nastrovia, bottoms up. Cheers. Oh, nice. See, I just seem to have flavoursome beers. I'm really lucky. I've got a little shop that's near me that sell all weird and wonderful foods from, like I say, from kind of Eastern European countries and that, and Russia, Poland, Lithuania, Latvia, and whatever, all those other ones that I can't think of offhand. But yeah, all those kind of countries and that, and I just feel so blessed. I'm just walking there. It's just a 5 minutes walk away from me. Come out with a big bag of all sorts of lovely things, and not have to order it online and that, you know. Nothing wrong with ordering it online, but you have to kind of, it's like visiting the doctor nowadays, you know. you have to kind of plan 4 weeks in advance whether you're going to be ill that night, you know. It's like, oh, right, I'll phone up the doctor. Can I book in for 3 weeks' time? Yeah, I'm thinking I might probably be ill then. How do you know? You know, how do you know you're going to fancy a beer that night when you're ordering it up like weeks in advance and it? So, you know, if I fancy a beer, I can walk 5 minutes over the road, get a load of lovely little East European beers and it. Anyway, get on with the bloody review, tell. I'm sorry, I really am sorry. I don't know how you folks put up with me, I really don't. Tiny bits of toffee in there. A lovely malty background note. Not massive amounts of fruit, but you've got a little bit of kind of little edges of marmalade in there. A slight, something, one of these kind of ready sort of fruits, like a slight edge of like a dried cherry or something like that. Bit more. Just had a mouthful of beer and I burped through my nose. It's horrible, isn't it? You can't open your mouth and go burp because it'll go blah. Really fine that way. Well, I'll be in mental one, I will. Not that I ain't already. This is why I'm stuck in the corner. It's broom cupboard, really. Oh, that is really nice. That is really nice. I like that. It's kind of, it's weird, it's not a complex beer, it's really flavoursome, but it's not one of these complex beers where you go, let's have a sit down and think, but it's really flavoursome, and that's lovely, that really is lovely. But it's kind of all toffees and things like that, it's all kind of fairly generic malty flavours, but it is lovely, really is lovely. And it's quite warming as well. You can feel it, not right into the stomach, but down the esophagus and that. It kind of just warms on the way down there. And kind of does its thing. Lovely stuff. Lovely, lovely stuff. Right, what do I think? I think, buy it, try it, like it. Definitely, definitely. That's quite lovely. Cheers, bottoms up. I'm going to clear this off, I think. Cheers, bubbles up. Chin chin. Nostrovia. How'd you say? What languages am I missing? I'm missing German, you know. Danish is, I think, Skål. You got Nostrovia. You got Salute. You got Yakidar, I believe. Whatever. Anyway, cheers to everyone. Up your bottoms. Cheers. More. Cheers.